1983, you went on your like first big tour, and of course Metallica went with you. So, you know, what were they like back then, and what was it like touring with them?
That was our first US tour. We get the offer to do a tour in America, and John Z tells us, "I've got this great opening band for you. They're the biggest band in San Francisco." And we're like, "What? Y&T want to open for us?" "No, not Y&T, Metallica." I'm like, "Who?" And then we heard the music, and it sounded like Motorhead played at the wrong speed. We're like, "All right, this sounds good. Let's take these guys." So we did. That was their first tour, was opening for us in America. And it was chaotic and crazy and a lot of fun.
Okay, well, what were the, you know, James, Kirk, and Lars were, you know, now in Metallica, you know, Rob, of course, was way younger then. He was not part of Metallica. But you know, what were these three guys like back then and compared them to now? I mean, what were, you played with them in 2014 in Sao Paulo, I think you opened for them. You know, how can you compare these three guys back in 83 and now?
Well, the surprising thing was that they haven't changed that much, considering the life experience they've been through and how much older they are. Obviously, I mean, James is a man now, and before he was a little kid, basically, with a can of beer in his hand, laughing all the time. That's all he ever did, was just giggle and drink beer. Lars hasn't changed one bit. He's still the shyster. He's still the, you know, the man with the eye on the prize. He's always working an angle. He's never changed at all. And Kirk's the same happy-go-lucky guy, you know, he was when he was a young kid. And, of course, back then, the older influence, even though he wasn't that much older, was Cliff, who was like an old soul on young shoulders, you know.
Yeah.
So it was great. We, you know, me and Cliff would sit and discuss music and play riffs at each other with basses and what about this and what about this. And he was very cool, definitely.
Okay, well, you know, those were, I know, from what I've heard at least, I mean, I wasn't even born back then, but, you know, I heard those were pretty wild times, the early 80s. Are there any, like, crazy stories from your time touring with Metallica in USA?
Well, we did play some very crazy places. We played down in the South, places where we've never actually played ever again, like in Arkansas. We woke up, we're apparently in a field, and we looked over the edge of the field, and it was a natural bowl with a stage at the bottom with totem poles on it and insects the size of small helicopters floating around. And we played there to a crowd of about 3,000 people, and it was just like playing on another planet. It was very weird. And then we played a 10,000-seat arena in Little Rock, Arkansas, where the guy said, "Hey, I just heard you guys sold out Madison Square Garden." And we're looking at him like, "Oh boy, are you in for a surprise?" Because of course we hadn't. We were there with equipment to play, you know, 300 seat clubs in a 10,000 seat arena with 200 people in evidence. It was embarrassing to say the least. That was strange. And then we played the best one is in Oklahoma. Have you seen the movie The Blues Brothers?
Yeah, but it was a long time ago. You need to remind me exactly about
the part where they come on, they steal the gig from the country band, and they're playing at Bob's Country Bunker, and there's a chicken wire, and the people are throwing stuff at them.
Yeah.
Well, we played a place just like that, but there wasn't any chicken wire. They were just throwing stuff at us.
Why? So
they threw because they were rowdy and drunk. They were throwing stuff at Metallica all the way through the set. Metallica just kind of turned their back on the crowd and got through it as quickly as they could. But we're used to playing rowdy places in England, so we got on stage and started throwing stuff back at them and kicking their beer over, and it was very strange.
Thanks for watching, and if you want more music news, just subscribe to Ultimate Guitar TV and press that little bell to get notifications.